Hey everyone, this time on Tim Talks Audio, we're moving past the channel strip plugin and working with the Pro EQ inside Studio One. In a previous video, we talked about the EQ available to us on the channel strip plugin that comes default with all versions of Studio One. Now, we're going to take those same concepts that we learned in that video and expand upon them with the Pro EQ. On the channel strip plugin, you're a little limited because you have a cutoff frequency for the low ends that you can adjust, a low shelving band, a high shelving band, and a mid parametric band. But you can't really adjust the bandwidth other than using the adaptive Q. With the Pro EQ plugin, you get two additional mid bands, and you can change the shape of the low and high bands, making them shelving EQs or more peak EQs. And on every single band, you have the ability to adjust the Q or bandwidth of that section of EQ. Let's take a look. Now you can see I have more bands available to me, as well as a low cut frequency, and in this one, a high cut frequency. My five bands that are available to me on the Pro EQ all have the same boost and cut control, frequency sweeps, and this is your Q or bandwidth control. On the channel strip, it was an adaptive Q, but on the Pro EQ, you set this yourself. Let me show you. I'll make a big boost here, and you can see that the shape didn't change as I boosted it. That's controlled here with the Q. A smaller number is a much wider bandwidth, and a bigger number is a much narrower bandwidth. On the Pro EQ as well, for the high frequency and the low frequency, we can change the shape and have it be a shelving EQ, or just like the low mid, mid, and high mid frequencies, a peaking EQ. Also on the Pro EQ, you have the ability to change the amount of cutoff per active. The smaller the amount, the more gentle the cutoff is. And the larger the amount, the more hard it is. This is the hardest, and this is the softest. You can see it's much more gentle, as opposed to the hardest, which is much more extreme. That's all for now. If you found anything informative, please like and share this video. If you have a question, please leave a comment, and I'll answer it in a future video. Thanks for watching.